I just wanted to delete a character and it bugged out. Anyway, I can still create a new character. Let's go.
This land is peaceful. I must warn them before Ryer scorches this place to ash.
Wait, what's this ring mail? Not really that useful. I think I pass on killing those little maybe not. They actually give some reasonable experience. Yeah, that was almost 20%. Okay, the Phoenix got lost, too bad. As I said before, I'm just gonna go and hope that shit just dies. Because the shit dies, some crawlers killed by the...
So much destruction. And for what?
And Graal also kills some enemies. Yeah. Okay, and now the forged soldier. I definitely see benefit of killing the Phoenixes, but I'm still not sure about that group at the end of the... what's its name? It doesn't even show. The first area. The Old Road, yeah, that's what this was called. Ooh, haste, shine, gimme. Actually, I want this potion. Okay. So far, so good. Another haste shrine. Stupid of me. Okay, I managed to survive. And where are you coming from? Couldn't you have come earlier? Also, I see that really what really helped here was Vitality. What's its name? Sunrise Emblem, which gave me a chance to ignite. It really helped. That's actually an Oh, I almost forgot. I need to spec into Rive. Okay. Jade Ring.
This way. You're here to have a deathless of the drink. Good careful.
Okay, no shrine here. This
I cannot do that.
Warrior's Great Maze, that's not really what I need. No shrine here either, huh? Beer. That's a pretty good time so far.
I'm sure you have questions, but let me first check and make sure the epoch's safe.
I guess I'm gonna risk it.
Good.
Oh, you have to click on the fucker. I just lost some time because of this idiocy. But still, saved a fair bit of time. Optimizing helped, but also got some good luck. Let's see, no shopping. I am, but as we say in Poland, nie mów hop, dopóki nie przeskoczysz. Don't say hop before you jump. There's still a long time in this run. I can lose it all in a moment. Root stuff is like whatever. Healing Oven Ox. I hate those rares with Oven Ox mod. Ooh. Eye the bow. Of a turtle. Give me this. Thank you. What's up? Those are pretty good gloves. Throwing attack speed is not necessarily something I need, but better than nothing, I suppose. Although I still need a bit of experience before I can even use that. Okay, well, let's pack the enemies up a bit here, and let's start Camarin. Those potions behind me. Am I really holding the right spear? I can't even tell because menus are glitching. Yeah. I guess not having any... not having two silver rings really matters because I feel way slower than usually. Maybe because I played my endgame character right before when testing shit, it makes everything feel so slow. But no, I recall that with two silver rings I'm significantly faster than this. Pretty shitty rolls on this spike. So shitty with the weapons. Okay. Okay. Can I have more weapons? Ooh, Mercurial Boots, gimme. Oh, can't use them until level 8.
Speaking of, let's head back to camp. I must reach Lena at once.
Ooh, good spawn.
He's back. He's been...
You're back. Lena, I'm sorry to...
No, god damn it. No silver rings, okay. Nothing really I need.
did the Ospreys go? I'll have to check my surroundings.
Mercurial boots with lots of oh, those are very good. I need to check after this lunge what level do I need for those boots. Level 8. Okay, I don't spec into anything just yet. Really? Of the orcs? For those who don't know, mod of the orcs makes enemies have significantly more life. That's pretty annoying. And all that just so the fucker could give me a wand. Lame. Okay, I see that this fucker is a bit too tanky. Wait, I'm already level 8. I can put my movement speed boots.
What brings you here? You cannot trace me.
Stand down or die.
Okay, I'm definitely over leveling here because my goal is to reach level 9, to be level 9 when I enter the refuge, which...
I cannot do that.
Keep them off me.
I'm gonna get some experience here in this fight. Okay, boss, and I have 6 animated weapons. Uh-oh, they are falling down. Give me this potion, actually. Still saved some time, so that's okay. I definitely see that that one rare was a total mistake. I fucked up royally. Okay. see. Oh, chance to bleed. That's actually gonna be good. Okay, so I want Hammer, got Nos here, and Shield Rush here. I still want some hammers because I feel like they might be occasionally useful. Maybe. The ox, I fucking hate that modifier. And let's see if they fixed Artem. They didn't.
What?
I don't need those gloves. Oh wait, I almost forgot. Spec into Shield Rush. That's important.
I cannot do that.
I won't be able to use it just yet because I won't have enough points, but
I cannot do that.
Wait, no, you don't go there, you go here. Promising. Unfortunately, don't have shield charge yet, so can't shield charge to the boss, but that's okay. What's this one? Ignite? Yeah, that one is good. Did I really just took like half his life in an instant? So give me this and this. Holy shit. I don't know what happened, but that was crazy that I they died so quickly. What is precipice? I actually never checked and I don't know definition of this word or Polish translation. I know I should check that later. Shrine of Ice Beetle. As nice as they are, I don't really care. Okay. Ooh, jade amulet, that's nice. And pretty good rolls too. I need to sell shit once I'm in town. Actually, I will be in town after the boss. Shoot, I routed a charge right at the start here and I already forgot about it. Bravo me! I think I decided that I'm not gonna shield charge, instead lunge, and then shield charge. And now I didn't get any spawns there. Absolutely ridiculous. And now Rive became very powerful. Be able to do a shield charge at the start because I don't have enough mana. Oh well. Those guards would just die because they create more problems than benefits. There we go, he died. Silver ring. That I switched off the warpath, and it actually would have been useful at this moment. Well, I done a mistake. Gotta live with it. This. Chopper.
Stand down or die.
I'm level 12, so I'm gonna need a bit more to use that cultist chopper. Anyway, a shield bash. Toxic of Slate, so it's probably poison damage and I don't even know what Slate does. Slow down? No, chill. Not on my watch with this stupid lightning attack. But I'll have to say, he used that attack very early in this fight. Oops, I went the wrong way. Luckily Sentinel is tanky, so... Timeless within reason. Okay, anyway. I shot a DSA save. I prefer mine. Don't need this. Don't need this either. Nothing I really need. Also funny that those gloves require level 15 and I got them like in Act 1.
You've woken up. Then close your eyes. I see that you are still you. That strength will be necessary if our world, our reality, is to have any hope. Why? Thank you. There is an
okay, now we go here just to get a quest for later. Now we're gonna move on. But first, let's put Holy Aura here, because I'm gonna need it. Well, not necessarily gonna need it, but it's a very useful thing. And I forgot already my setup at the start here. Well, that was good enough. Okay, here I move. I keep forgetting where to go. Okay, I think I'm gonna skip using any movement ability here at the very start to save mana. There are no enemies to launch to, and shield charges costs a lot.
Okay.
And I think in general this area is better for launch because, well, shield charge, as cool as it is, just keeps glitching. That was nice. They gathered around the boss, and then when I was about to unleash the 360, they moved in. Shoot, I forgot the setup at the start. Wait, it was from here and here. You'll see. No, but close enough. three guys at once. Avoid any obstacles? No.
I cannot do that.
Still, within reason. Okay. I should look for possibly better chopper. You don't have, unfortunately, anything. Oh, I can actually use this one already. Actually not 100% sure if that's an upgrade already, because my my mace was good, but nah, it's an upgrade. Okay, that one fucker doesn't matter. That was good. Well, okay, I could spawn the centipede faster, but it still was good. Actually, wait, because I leveled up, that means the goods here shuffled. Let's see. Wait. No, nothing good. I actually could have bought Mace of Rune of Shattering and shatter this. Oh well. Happened, rather. Nothing happened. Sure, that's a good angle. Oh, good enough. That's bad angle, however. As I said, there were enemies in the past here, but now they're burrowed. Making this area a bit more annoying. And there are no enemies here, which is, well, that's also annoying because I cannot lunge down there. Okay, Valoran Undercity is one of those places where lunge is actually better than shield charge. A few exceptions, but this is exception number two.
I cannot do that.
Ooh, physical resistance, that's good. Okay. Ooh. Am I really losing time on the splits now? Huh. Seems like I'm going to lose some time. That's okay, but still. This might be really that good. Can't really either tell where I'm exactly losing all that time. Anyway, fucker is dead. Whole minute on the split, huh? And I can't even tell where. It's really weird. Anyway, here I need to verify it. Yeah, okay. And I already forgot the angle you charge it down here, but that's okay. Not here yet. I totally botched this area. Well, that might be actually good. Okay, the time save here actually is gonna be fake because I'm not doing one quest right now. I'm gonna do it on the next split. So this is gonna be fake time save. Splitting here, skipping that split.
Great battle is lost here. Darkness is all that is left.
Yeah, I should have bought some Rune of Shattering and shattered my mace and crafted the flood damage on my axe. This one is not really much better, but I guess kinda better defensively, and crit chance, which I don't really scale, but might as well, I guess. Wait, now I go this way first. Wait, I do have a Rune of Shattering. So let's shatter this. Oh, Malakold. And now I'm gonna do the Rat City. And now, as I said, there's a glitch currently that you can skip going for the second key in the Lotus Halls, but I don't wanna use it, so we go for the second one. So I expect them to patch them on the next patch, and I wanna get prepared for it. Okay. I think he wants to go this way. I totally forgot what angle here. Okay, let's kill this fucker. This area.
I cannot do that.
That's not good, but okay. No, I botched this. I cannot do this area anymore. I keep crashing everywhere. Flip. I totally fucked up that quest, but whatever. I'm saving a little bit time because it's definitely faster to do this in this order. Anyway, on the next level, which is very shortly, I'm getting healing hands and then I'm popping off. But it's not a good base, but I could shatter it and put it on a good base like mine. I don't have any rounds of shattering though. I'm definitely losing a bit more time here. Or at the very least, I'm not saving time. I'm not killing Emperor in 10 seconds. And it's hard for me to pinpoint where I'm actually losing time. Digital the loot, but whatever. Let's just move on. Actually, first let's go to the shop. Dodge rating, for fuck's sake. Unlucky. I see I still have this typo I had for ages on the split. It's Admiral Harton, not Haron. I had two slices, so I regained some mana. Perfect.
I cannot do that.
A water shrine that actually would have been useful. But whatever. I know that you can destroy this with throwing. I kept destroying it with javelin back when I was using Holy Trail. Okay. And the reason why I did this quest now because, well, it saves me a long walk from where the Elder Gaspar put me to here. So long I can't even scroll there in time. Shot, I already forgot my setup for this area. Wait, was it so? No, I remember now. I moved into a different place and then from there I was using a better angle. That's okay. Nice shrine, let's go.
I cannot do that.
Totally botching this. And I think my PB in this category doesn't even use shield charge, only lunging with javelin. Do a charge. Hold up. Yeah, that's one problem I was worried about. I won't be able to do my setup. It's a really cool setup though. I just can't really do it fast enough. Hey, before you engage with those fuckers, you wanna go here to trigger the slaughtered trolls? Hey, I think 75% chance to trigger is good enough for me, for now.
Stand down or die.
Not sure about this angle. Yep. And I already also started too high. Still no drop of a quarter staff also, but that's the list of the concerns I have. Shot.
I cannot do that. I cannot do that.
That was a resistance idol, so not really something I need. Oh, skipped that.
I cannot do that.
Okay, Fallen Tower. I already forgot my angle for the first charge, but I also don't think I have mana for it, so... Eh, that was good enough. Also fucking up this area. Ooh, clerics or the amulet, gimme. Ooh, that was a real shit show. I totally botched that area. I shouldn't be fighting these queens. forgot my setup for this charge. Yep, totally botched this. That's actually a pretty good amulet, but I really want my movement, my attack speed from my jade amulet. So I guess I'm gonna try, what's its name, shattering it. Okay, no need to shield charge here at the start because it's all gonna get fucked, and then it gets fucked anyway. Okay, I'll let me go around. So enemies will. He's distracted by animated weapons. Interest. I really don't get why I'm losing so much time. Holy shit. Lost 2 minutes and I don't even know where. Holy shit. Is my PB that good? No, it can't be. I refuse to believe that. It's a small upgrade. And I also totally forgot the charges I do in that area, so fuck me. Okay, Majasan Desert, oh yeah, it's this one. Oh, that was a very bad angle. let's make it 100% chance to happen. What? What have killed me? Snake infection. Really? At the start? For fuck's sake. I didn't even notice me taking damage and then suddenly boom, you're dead. Also, fuck this winged carrion. What a shitty enemy. Forgot how you do this area. I cannot use this yet. And I also have no quarter staff yet, which I think is one of my problems with damage. Quarter staff at this point gives a lot of damage, like. And I forgot my setup for a charge here as well. Is actually a higher tier. And this one also has attack speed, which is good. I already forgot my setup, that's too steep of an angle. Yeah, let's just go. That's a shit show. Now for some reason I get no spawns of the wardens, which I mean is not a bad thing, but it's weird. Ooh, Imperial Halberd already. Here. Took you long enough. Oh, attack speed, that's pretty okay. think I prefer my armor. Anybody here? Nope. Oh yeah, so. I feel like I hit my hard limit for this game. Even though how much I try, I just can't seem to be able to improve. I would need also to watch Terek's video. He managed in one run to beat my full campaign time, so I definitely can learn something. Well, you're right, Noreb, but I often have times when speedrunning that I feel like I hit a hard wall, like a time I just, no matter what, cannot beat, even though I'd like to beat it. I guess the same is with 2-hour barrier in Diablo 2. Although I'll admit, I didn't put that much. Oh, I put a fair amount of time in this game. Hmm. Another Imperial Halberd, interesting.
I cannot do that.
But I haven't gotten a single, what's its name? A single quarter staff. That's interesting. Wow. Okay, you can fuck off. I think it'll be slightly faster to go like this. I'm gonna lose time on the split because of the death in previous area. That fucking death was really awful, like I didn't see that coming. It was death to an ailment. It's actually a new ailment exclusive to one single enemy. So it really caught me off guard. But hey, 120 Oracle's abode, that's a okay time. And I definitely could improve my time if the, what's its name, the quest that... Yes, they actually added a new ailment exclusive to one enemy. I'll take that for shattering, don't need this. Shatter. And it really caught me off guard when I got inflicted by it. I remember somebody on the early speedrunning Discord mentioned that it appeared and it looks really strong. Snake Venom. Oh, I didn't get a single shard I wanted. Yeah, like a poison. This one that killed me actually was called Snake Venom. Okay, that's a Okay, no. I thought I crashed later. That wasn't an acceptable place. Oh, I just realized something. I don't trigger the healing hands when I'm on negative mana because, well, that's how triggered skills work. Okay, so I need to be a little careful when I use aura during the combat.
I cannot do that.
Well, cautious is not the word I would use, more like conscious. Yeah, that's the good word. Mana. Lich Slayer. Lich Slayer? What is it? Path of Exile? It's a class that's literally Path of Exile. A Slayer that focuses on Lich. I actually played this season one Lich Slayer and he was good. Oh, I forgot that I wanted to have an ailment axe for this guy, because he can hide, but I got lucky he didn't aggro on any leeches, he aggroed on me. So that's good. Because he can aggro on leeches that we just passed, and slowly crawl to them hidden in his thing, and when he is hidden he blocks all the attacks. Oh no, he did aggro. And there's four of those leeches here. God damn it, Zarek, why did you do this even in the first place? That makes no sense. Yikes. And I feel like I also lost time to something else, not just... not just that unfortunate death earlier. In the past you had to wait for Alaric to activate the device, so that was perfect moment to have a drink or something. Yes, go here. And of course I crashed. Okay. Fun fact, I really don't like coffee, and yet I'm a caffeine addict because of caffeinated sodas. I just cannot stand the bitter flavor of coffee. Oh, I actually just remembered I had totally different setup for this place and now I forgot everything. Let's see. I also had a setup for this place and I forgot everything.
I cannot do that.
Oh, that was good enough though. That's also what I heard when I was doing it for. I was watching video of my one of my favorite culinary YouTubers, Alex French Guy Cooking, with some guy who's a coffee specialist and also a YouTuber. I forgot his name. I might try looking into it.
I cannot do that.
Hey Revzen, what's up? Yeah, I remember that there was some rainbow one-handed sword. Did someone find some crazy setup for it?
I cannot do that.
If I remember, that rainbow sword was actually insignificant for the most part. I'm not sure. I think well-rolled rare would be better, especially later, but I don't quite remember the stats on that sword. I haven't used this at all, and I haven't seen it in ages. Well, not that in ages, I actually saw that a while ago when browsing weapons on Ali Tools, but I didn't pay attention to it. Actually, I could get a look after this run, but if I remember, it's not that phenomenal. That here a long time already. Oh wait, I don't need the movement abilities in town to simulate online. Oh well, happened. Let's see, this one requires two more levels. Do you have anything interesting in the shop? Let's see. That's good for shattering. That's also good for shattering. Oops. That was lame. I got no shards at all. Higher level to forge this anyway, but I'm definitely putting increased extra flat damage on it. Fire is especially good because I scale it, so it's gonna go up. Okay, level 32. Level 35 I can get new skill, which would be healing, which would be the Sigil of Hope. Okay, can't quite get fast enough to catch that guy. He's going this way, but that's okay. Now this fucker dies way faster with healing hands than with javelin and holy trail, which I find pretty interesting. Healing effectiveness.
Stand down or die.
Okay. I guess I could quickly try to forge what I need. It feels to me that healing hands scales way better with healing effectiveness than I thought. Maybe it's even more beneficial to start scaling this way earlier.
Stand down.
And just leave the melee conversion for later? That would be an option. Oh boy, The end of that was crazy.
This was once Solarum, my home, but now it is a monument to death.
Expecting you. It was a trap!
You should have seen death.
I've heard of your power. Let's see.
Enough! No more games.
Shaman? Wait, Shaman is Totem. Yeah, so I guess more of a caster, but can be melee too, I guess. Oh wait, Totem is only one of the specialties. I would say the specialty of Shaman is more like elemental damage in general. Artem, can you come here or something? Okay, Zarek, you've come, thank you. Classes in LA are pretty good. Some better than other, clearly, like for example, Paladin clearly outclasses other two. Okay, now we go back. Oh wait, no, Ancient Hunt.
I cannot do that.
Scavenger, Raya Swarpuff. The sounds those flame paladins make, I find them pretty funny.
I
something with healing effectiveness. But I missed what that was. Whatever. Yeah, I think specking into healing effectiveness early on healing hands, as well as picking early the divine bolt thing, so it scales with our attacks, might be the play. Well, not our attacks, with healing hands 3. Last week I had this cutscene glitch out on me, so glad that it didn't happen today. To go shopping, not really. Shop here is in a pretty awkward spot.
Yes. Farewell.
Okay, we're gonna go get things for this guy, so he can make his potion. Oh shoot! I think I wanted to do a charge like this at the start of this area. Yes, that is correct. Oh wait, I just remembered that I routed this a bit differently. This charge already was getting me far enough right here. Oh! So no need to stop there. Pick the quest for this from this guy, I mean.
I cannot do that.
Wait. Oh yeah, I'm going the wrong way, fuck me. Thought something was looking fishy.
I cannot do that. I cannot do that.
Okay. Now we spec into sigils. We put instant casts to make them very... Well, this is mostly a quality of life TBH. Oh. That brute I had to kill there died so quickly I didn't even notice. Lol. Okay, I definitely will say I was underestimating how powerful the healing effectiveness scaling for this skill is.
I cannot do that.
Ah. Aha. You casted that attack in the wrong moment. Now you're mine. This stupid avalanche is like... Have you seen how long it goes on for? Imperial. It's ridiculous. Anyway, I imagine that shield charge here would be good. Well, almost good, but good enough. This and let's go this.
I cannot do that. I cannot do that.
Already on top. Okay, I know where am I now.
I cannot do that.
Now I charge to the side and straight to the exit. Okay, that was good. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Calm down. Just run on the thin air, and we're in the Temple of Heorot. Who I kept misnaming as Herodot? Oh, I actually wanted to check who was Herodot, because I bet he was ancient Greek or ancient Roman. Shrine, but at this point it doesn't matter. Okay, now the annoying boss. But I'm fairly tanky, so... Okay, that was pretty good. And I already forgot my setups for this location. Well, fuck me, I guess. I definitely see that, what's its name, Sigils of Hope does a lot of good for this build. Like, I actually never really liked Sigils of Hope before because, well, they pain in the ass to maintain, but when you make them instant like I did and use with Rive, they become actually very efficient. They have good benefits too. And truth be told, you shouldn't even be using sigils for clear, because you should have enough damage already from other sources. And I also have a passive on Healing Hands that gives me more damage per point, per level of a buff skill. And Healing Hands, you guessed it, is a buff skill. So just being specced into it gives me more damage.
Stand down. I cannot do that.
Which I find pretty cool.
I cannot do that. I cannot do that.
Actually, better would have been to pick the other attunement node earlier on that also gives elemental resistance. But whatever, this one is just as good. It gives me extra healing effectiveness for healing hands. That's what... Attunement does for healing hands, gives extra healing effectiveness, so... Damn it, Grail, you didn't stun him in time. Oh, I'm actually saving time here, it seems. Now I just need to turn in the quests. I might be saving a little bit. Well, I definitely had slightly better movement in a couple places, and also because I specced into Healing Hands, boss went faster. Okay, Immortal Empire. Yep, saved some time. This still might be sub 2 hours then. I really need to buy a new webcam because this one is dated.
I cannot do that.
Right, and as I established, it's actually slightly faster to go here.
I cannot do that.
Ooh! I almost hit what I wanted last time. That death sound was very funny. I can't even recreate it, but it sounded like deflating balloon. Okay, Sapphire Tablet. And I just need to turn in both quests, so... Ah, I crashed, but not where I expected to. I thought I'm gonna crash on that Thingama Bob. Actually, this Thingama Bob, this piece of wood stuck in the ground, that's the worst part about this that area. I kinda wonder if words Aria and Arena are related, because I keep misusing them, well, swapping them by accident. Fire tablet, let's... Okay, not quite sub 2 hours, but close. Without a dev, that definitely would have been sub 2 hours. Okay, and now Ancient Hunt. I can't really tell where I'm losing all that time. 15-8. So let's finish it on my favorite note. The Rat City. Rat City? Very well. If humanity survives this, we'll never forget the memory of Rat City. Long live Rat City! Oh, I actually saved 9 seconds. So yeah, last week I figured that Forgeguard is a bait. This guy has added void damage, but I don't scale void, so I'm not sure. But today it seems like this healing effectiveness scaling on healing hands is higher than I expected, so... maxing this, then with point in this, and then going healing effectiveness is gonna be the play. And instead of this, even though mana regen is nice, I think Defiance would be better. And also because healing effectiveness proved to be so good, I guess I originally wanted to rush for this because, what's its name? This allows me to scale it with my weapon, melee weapon, but because this is so strong, I think going this 6 points first, then we could go Bane of Evil and Divine Catalyst, and then go here. Maybe even go 1, 2, 3 like this, because I have where is it, here, 20% chance to cast the Divine Bolt on melee hit. And actually I could also pick this one, this will reduce chance to 18%, which is still pretty good, but make me fire 2 bolts. Problem with that, it's the Divine Bolt flies at random,